Hey guys, it's Alex from Source Distribution. We are here in beautiful Sydney, Australia, which is the home of spiders, kangaroos, koalas, and also Ryan Burke of RØDE Microphones.
Welcome. Thanks for joining us, Alex.
Ryan's going to give us a tour of RØDE headquarters. And what's amazing about this place is this isn't just the place where they have their offices and they design the products, but this is also the manufacturing facility for the product. So we're going to get a sneak peek of the incredible processes that are in play in here, which all result in making amazing, consistent products. So Ryan, should we check it out?
Let's go have a look. Come on.
So Ryan, where are we now and why are we wearing these awesome hats?
We are in the capsule assembly chamber at RØDE, and this is a clean room, so we have to wear the lab coats, the lovely footwear, and the hairnets, because we have to make sure that no dust gets in this room whatsoever. The air is always flowing out, and it makes sure that the capsules are always pristine.
And so what is made here? What products get assembled here?
So at the moment, we're assembling large diaphragm capsules, so things that you'll find in like the K2, the NT1. We also do the smaller half-inch capsules, and we also make the new ribbon elements here as well. This is the capsule cell. Now you are looking at robotic arms that are machining capsules, the back plates of capsules, and getting them to within fractions of a micron of flatness and twist, meaning that every capsule that comes out of this machine is completely matched. Yeah. So what you're seeing right now, this machine actually uses a pure diamond bit.
So the idea is that the consistency between capsule to capsule is like insanely similar. Like
as close as you can measure.
They are basically all matched.
They are, they're the same when they come out.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
What we do in this room is we actually manufacture the circuit boards that go into the microphones, and this is how we bring the NT1, which is the world's quietest studio microphone, to life. It all starts out here. Now this is a humidity and temperature controlled chamber that just keeps our parts in the perfect condition so that they don't actually get exposed to the elements before they're placed on a board. We just type in what actual microphone we're going to be making, parts will come out, they can place them in the little rack, and then it goes onto the SMT machine which loads the components. But before that happens, the solder paste is actually silk screened over the actual unit. So this is a circuit board before, so, oh, well, there you go. So we're looking at the RØDE Link transmitter.
Yeah.
And it goes into this machine right here, which silk screens solder paste over the board. So what happens then is just over those exact sections at the perfect thickness, you'll get the solder paste silk screened. It comes into this machine here, and then these are all the components that get picked up by the machine, and they get rapid fired onto the board extremely fast. So what you see there is the camera actually takes a picture, scans the components to make sure it's been picked up properly before they actually get chucked down on the board, so you know that you've never missed a component. We buy these machines so that we can keep complete control over it.
You know exactly
that way we
what
know.
Parts are going in as well. You're not getting skipped on parts.
And we're not fulfilling quotas, you know, of boards to send to multiple manufacturers. We do microphones and we do them damn well. And then from there, once the parts are loaded, they're automatically sent through to this pizza oven looking machine. And what that does is it gently heats the board, and that will travel through this machine very slowly. It's hottest right in the center, then they kind of gently cool down once again. This is where your NT1 started before it was in a microphone. This is all an automated process for the machines.
So the whole, all your PCBs are made here?
Yes,
yeah, we make control.
All the electronics are made in-house, and we do that in this room, which we're expanding at the moment just because, you know, the more products you have, the more time you need on the machine. Now, if you have ever wondered how we actually label microphones and get the serial numbers on board and go from something like this to something like that. Lasers. Does it get any cooler than lasers?
Definitely
I don't know.
Not.
So these machines actually automatically go through. We load up all the microphones and they will put on consecutive serial numbers so that we can track a microphone the whole way through its life. And that's how you get from a regular painted finish to a nice lasered finish like that. And the important thing with that is that it's not painted on, it's not going to rub off. We can simulate the life cycle of a product within a couple of weeks. We can test them at all sorts of temperatures.
Oh my God, it's like an oven.
Exactly, and we can simulate, you know, 10 years worth of usage in a condensed amount of time just by exposing it to different humidities, different temperatures. I mean, this is how we can offer such a good warranty. For instance, right now, there is a salt spray test being done. This machine's actually got river motors in there checking over time how much they can handle when it comes to salt spray. That'll also have implications on whether your moisture saliva, from your mouth, yeah, everything. Like, yeah, just, the element is getting sprayed for 2 hours.
Yeah.
Then we'll take it out for quite a few weeks and we'll just monitor what happens of that amount of time.
Is it like oxidizes?
Exactly.
Or like you're just sort of being harsh and then letting it dry? And
that's it. And yeah, we can simulate what's going to happen. And then onwards, we'll check out the paint line. And we use the term paint very loosely because we don't paint our products, yeah, we ceramic coat them. So what you're seeing in here, which is quite a noisy room, right now this is M5 bodies. So what you're seeing here is the bodies after they've come through the oven. So what happens is they get loaded up, they're bead blasted, as you can see, we're loading them up right now.
So this is where you sort of like roughen the surface of the brass.
Exactly. So if you come through, it's charged at 10,000 volts, and this is negatively charged. So there's a positive charge on the paint, this is negatively charged, and they spin around and wobble. So we want them to wobble like this, so you get even coating, and then they spin, and what that means is that you get total even coverage, but because the particles are charged, they actually stick to the body, like they're attracted to the body. You get perfect coating. That's where you can see, it's quite hot, so just watch yourself there, but you can see it's baking at a super high temperature, but that's going to cure that finish and makes it rock solid. And I mean, this is military grade. This is what they use to coat firearms that are going out in the field. I mean, who else is doing that for a home recording microphone, studio recording microphone, you know, broadcast microphone? It's ceramic coated. It's amazing. This is what your NTG4 or NTG4 Plus starts out as before it becomes a microphone.
Okay, wow.
So this is just a raw bar.
Is it solid?
Aluminium. It's solid.
Wow. Right,
we have machining out of solid bars.
So you literally start with the raw materials.
We are starting with raw materials, and the whole process is done. So I mean, you can see this has been cut off once it's been machined into a body. Now these machines are multi-axis lathes. So what they're doing is they're actually spinning the product around, and the bits are coming in and actually machining every single angle on the microphone.
The little screw holes and all the burrs and like bits and bobs of the body.
Yeah, so we get the product as a raw solid bar.
Yep.
This is a line tube for an NTG4. So this is where it starts out. This is what actually does the acoustic cancellation of the microphone at the very bottom level, and then on the outside you've got the other fins that'll kind of dictate that. But that has just come out of that solid bar that I've just shown you.
So the machine is just spin, turn, drill, cut, done all of the...
All multiple angles. Yeah. And what happens is that we get a lot of this extra material that you can see down here. So we've got all this extra material, and what happens is we actually box it all up and we send it back to where we bought the bars from, and they melt it back down and we start again. Nice. Now, this kind of feels like you're walking through an evil lair.
I totally feel like I'm playing a computer game in this room.
It's like 007. So, can you guess what's in this next room?
I don't know, but this is a very reverberant space, which feels like a nice counter to what I think is coming.
Well, this next room, although this is incredibly roomy right now because of all the flat surfaces, this next room has no reflections. Okay, welcome to the RØDE anechoic chamber. And just give me a moment, I'm going to close the doors here and you are going to hear how scarily quiet it is in here. And I say that because in a few moments you're going to start hearing your heartbeat and your blood rushing through your body.
This is really weird. This isn't a natural space. I mean, obviously, this is an unnatural space. This does not exist in the natural world.
There's not a single place in the natural world that will sound like this. And interestingly enough, it starts to affect your balance after some time because humans rely on reflections all around to actually know their exact position and the position of things. You know, if I start like turning away from you right now, you know, like you can just immediately notice. Yeah.
It's like, so there are no reflections. We're obviously used to living in the world, and there are reverberant spaces, canyons, and the houses we build, even in tiny rooms, there's the tiniest little reflection which gives your ears the clues, and there's just none.
There's none. I mean, if you just admire the silence for a moment. Now that is silence. Now the idea of an anechoic chamber is that these massive wedges are absorbing all reflections. They're loosely filled at the front, they're really densely filled at the back. Right. And if you haven't noticed, this spring floor that
we're not exactly on a normal floor here.
No, so there's the exact same thing on the ceiling, there's the exact same thing on the floor. When we're in the middle of this room, any reflections, any sounds being completely absorbed, nothing comes back. It was made specifically for us, for this environment, and it was shipped over in 6 40-foot containers. It took, you know, a couple of weeks for the guys to build it.
Who else has this?
Nobody to my knowledge. I mean, no, most universities, no mic manufacturers that I know of have a facility of this scale.
What is the benefit to the customer? Why do you have this? Because this is obviously a major investment.
The only way that you can know for sure what your microphone is doing is going into a completely silent space like this with no reflections. And then we can do a frequency sweep and we can actually check exactly what the microphone is picking up.
So that concludes the whistle stop tour of RØDE. I hope you get a sense of the level of investment that these guys have made into manufacturing their products. I heard about this stuff, but this is actually the first time I've seen it, and it is insane. There are not many mic manufacturers in the world. In fact, there are no mic manufacturers in the world that have all of the capability that the guys have in this building. So it means that they're able to make really, really good products at an insanely affordable price. Long may that continue. Thanks very much for watching and catch you next time. Cheers.